Hello, and from the Dental Learning Center, I'm your host, Dr. Buster Bedcheck. With me today at the Dental Learning Center is Dr. Marie Huggy. Hello, Marie. Today we'll discuss Pontic design. Although many designs have been suggested, we'll talk about two, the modified ridge lap, and the ovate pontic. Dr. Huggy, why should the dentist worry about pontics these days?
Some patients may not desire implant therapy, or would be better treated with a conventional, fixed partial denture. As you noted, numerous designs have been proposed for pontics that may be used for conventional and implant-supported restorations. Diagnostic waxing should be performed to examine the predictability of the restoration.
If the restoration can be successfully simulated on the cast, then the restoration can be performed in the mouth.
Right. The condition of the residual ridge must be carefully considered. Vertical and horizontal defects of the pontic area may be treated in close consultation with the periodontist or oral surgeon. Misaligned teeth may require orthodontic treatment. Strength is of fundamental importance in the design of the pontic. A weak connector is more likely to undergo flexure with fracture of porcelain and breakage of the connector. The pontic should be hygienic and easy for the patient to clean. Hopefully, it does not become a food trap or an annoyance to the tongue, lip, or cheek.
Aesthetics is frequently an overriding consideration, especially restorations in the front of the mouth.
A type of pontic that in many cases is both aesthetic and reasonably hygienic is the modified ridge lap pontic, shown in the diagram. The pontic connector should be as bulky as space and aesthetics permits. Fabrication of the metal casting should be calibrated to receive the optimal layer of veneering material. The tissue surface of the pontic may be of highly polished metal, but space permitting, porcelain may be used on the tissue surface of the pontic, up to a 2 mm thick layer. This porcelain must be glazed or highly polished after adjusting. It is important that the connector not be weakened, so this modification should not be used on short teeth.
Okay, Marie. What can you tell us about the ovate pontic?
Very often, an anterior tooth must be extracted and an immediate provisional restoration placed. The ovate pontic, seen in the diagram, may be used to guide the healing process. The abutment teeth are prepared prior to the extraction. Socket preservation procedures are carried out, and the provisional restoration fabricated. The ovate pontic should extend approximately 2.5 mm into the socket space, and be approximately 1 mm from the alveolar interceptal and facial bone. During successive follow-up appointments, the coronal segment of the pontic is reduced to facilitate flossing. The tissue surface of pontics should rest passively without blanching on keratinized tissue. Regular flossing under the pontic is essential for the tissue to remain in a healthy state. One should avoid the creation of concave surfaces. If possible, interim prostheses should simulate the shape of the final restoration as much as possible to allow the patient to adapt to the new restoration and voice any concerns they may have. These pontic designs may generally be used in all areas of the mouth. Particularly in areas of low aesthetic requirement or long spans, porcelain coverage is minimized, or even eliminated to enhance the rigidity of the framework.
This is Dr. Buster Bedcheck thanking you for joining us at the Dental Learning Center. Please join us again.